Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. We've already looked at the use of touch in Project 2013, and we'll be using touch at various points during the course. And we've also seen how to switch between mouse mode and touch mode. Now, for many people, they either prefer to use the keyboard, or in some cases, they have to use the keyboard. Some people suffer from things like repetitive strain injury, RSI, from using a mouse too much, and they find it much less troublesome to use the keyboard. For other people, the keyboard may be the only option available to them. So being able to operate Project using the keyboard, or using the keyboard as much as possible, is either a preference or necessary for many people. So in this section, I'm going to take a quick look at the facilities for using the keyboard in Project 2013. Now, the first thing to point out is that when we looked at help earlier on in the course, and we found that this question mark icon is the one to use, if you hover over it, you get a screen tip. The screen tip says help, and then in brackets, F1. F1, the F1 function key on your keyboard, is the keyboard shortcut for help. And in fact, many of the commands on the Project 2013 ribbon and many other aspects of using Project 2013 can be driven by keyboard shortcuts. Now, we are going to come across various keyboard shortcuts during the course, and I will mention the key ones as we go along. But I must also confess that I am not a great user of keyboard shortcuts myself, mainly because I use very many different pieces of software, and if I tried to remember all the keyboard shortcuts, there would just be hundreds and hundreds, and I'd get hopelessly confused. Having said that, many of the keyboard shortcuts associated with common operations, such as copy and paste type operations, I do remember, and I do use them all the time. If you look at the ribbon here for Project 2013, if I hover over a particular command, let's choose that one, Team Planner, you get a screen tip. It says Team Planner, but note that there is no sign of a keyboard shortcut. Let's hover over another one, Resource Usage, Resource Sheet. You see how with these there is no keyboard shortcut. But if I go to another command, such as that one, I get a screen tip, and note, I get a keyboard shortcut as well. So if you want to just check the keyboard shortcuts, hovering over a command on the ribbon will tell you whether it has a keyboard shortcut or not. And if you're good at remembering keyboard shortcuts, once you've identified that, then maybe that's a good basis for you using that keyboard shortcut again in the future. Now, if you want or need to use keyboard shortcuts, there's something that will really help you. And that is, if you go into the Project Help, the online version, under Getting Started, one of the entries there is Project Keyboard Shortcuts. And if you click on that link, it takes you to a document that lists the Project Keyboard Shortcuts. Now, there's an explanation of the what and why of keyboard shortcuts, and then there's a categorized list of the Microsoft Office basic keyboard shortcuts. That's the ones that are pretty much common across all of Microsoft Office. And then there are the ones specifically related to Microsoft Project. Now, I know that some people print these lists out and stick them on the wall if they use keyboard shortcuts quite a lot. Maybe you're very good at remembering keyboard shortcuts. And of course, how many of these keyboard shortcuts you need to know depends on what you do with Microsoft Project. So you may not need all of them anyway. But if you want or need to use keyboard shortcuts, that's a pretty comprehensive list available there via Help. So now there's one other aspect of keyboard shortcuts which is very important, and that is that knowing those keyboard shortcuts doesn't necessarily help you to find your way around the ribbon. And given that the ribbon is so pivotal in terms of your use of Project 2013, what you need is a facility to help you use the ribbon using the keyboard. Now, the facility that's provided is a facility that's usually referred to as Keytips. And basically, with the ribbon as it is in front of you now, if I press the Alt key, what happens is that you get a load of little symbols that appear. And these symbols are effectively the keyboard shortcuts to operate various commands on the quick access toolbar and on the ribbon. Now, if we start with the quick access toolbar, if you look at the top there, they're numbered 1 to 5. 2 and 3 are grayed out. You can't undo or redo because we haven't done anything and we haven't undone anything to redo. But save is enabled. The button to switch between touch and mouse is enabled, and the quick print button is enabled. And to do a save, I would just hit 1 on the keyboard. To enable the facility to switch between touch and mouse, that's 4. Quick print, that's 5. As far as the ribbon itself goes, then the letters there, F-H-U-S-R-W, they let me choose which tab I want to operate. So if I wanted to go to the project tab, I would press the R key. Press R, and once I'm on the project tab, I then get a single or double letter keyboard shortcut to operate any of the enabled commands. So P would operate that subproject command, AP, apps for office, I, project information, and so on. So I could basically operate the tabs on the ribbon and every individual command on the ribbon using keyboard shortcuts. When I finish using keyboard shortcuts, press the Alt key again and they disappear. So that's keyboard shortcuts and key tips in Project 2013. I'll see you in the next section.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.